Hi, my name is Gary Eckstein from organicweb.com.au. I'm a Mailchimp Pro partner. One of the things I get most often about Mailchimp in regards to email marketing is how can the sender stop emails going to a recipient's or a subscriber's spam folder? Also, in Gmail, how can we minimize the chance that our emails go to the promotions folder? We can do this by authenticating our domain. In this video, I'm going to show how we authenticate our domain using Bluehost. Now, Bluehost is a very popular web host. I've already done videos in the past on GoDaddy and Cloudflare, but today it's about Bluehost. So if you use Mailchimp to send email marketing, you use Bluehost, this is really something you need to do. You will reduce the chance of your emails going to the spam folder, as well as the Gmail promotions folder. Let's go across to Mailchimp. I'm in my demo account in Mailchimp at the moment. I'm going to view the domains I have in Mailchimp. To do that, and there are various ways to do this, we can quite simply click website, the website icon to the left of the screen. And then you'll notice that I can click domains. Under email domains, it lists the domains from which I may send in Mailchimp. So I send my email marketing and it looks like it's from, let's say, gary@55tips.com, etc. If you want to add more domains, if you own more domains and want to add them and be able to send from them in Mailchimp, all you do is click verify email and send yourself an email from within Mailchimp. Click send verification email. You'll receive an email which you just need to click on, and then you'll be able to send from your account in Mailchimp as if you're on that domain you've added. So once you've clicked on that email in Mailchimp or that you've received, you will have a blue verified next to your domain name. What we want to do is we want to get to green authenticated. Green authenticated is where we'll get less of our emails going to the spam folder. As mentioned, I'm going to show today in Bluehost. To get from blue verified to green authenticated, which is what you want to do, we do this. We click authenticate, and then Mailchimp gives us various instructions that we need to do in Bluehost. So just bear with me. We're going to be going backwards and forwards just a little bit between Bluehost and Mailchimp, but it will make sense. Before I start off, let's go now across to Bluehost. So I'm in Bluehost. I've logged in to Bluehost. I click domains to the left-hand side, and you'll be able to see the domains you have on Bluehost. In this case, what I'm wanting to do, and I'll go back to Mailchimp, I'm actually wanting to authenticate plusmarketingapp.com for reliable sending from Mailchimp. So back here, so what I do is domains, and then next to the domain that I want to authenticate, I click manage. There's a lot of stuff going on here, but just scroll down a little bit till you get to the CNAME part. Let's go back to Mailchimp. So to authenticate plus marketing app, I click authenticate in Mailchimp to the right-hand side of the screen, and Mailchimp gives us the various instructions. So what I want to do here is I want to copy that bit, the K2 dot underscore and so on. Just copy that. Come back to Bluehost. Click add record to the right of CNAME. And merely paste in that information. Back to Mailchimp. Copy this DKIM2 dot etc. Just copy that. Back to Bluehost, and let's paste it in there. You can leave the TTL or the time to live, that's fine, and we click save. We're going to add another record, so let's go back to Mailchimp, and we're on the second CNAME record we need to create. Create a second CNAME, so copy the K3 dot, so copy that section, come back to Bluehost. Again, we click add record. We click and paste in the first field, back to Mailchimp, copy the DKIM3 dot, copy that, back to Bluehost and paste that information in there. You can leave the TTL and we click save. So what we're expecting to see once we've saved in Bluehost the CNAME records we've added, we expect to see the two CNAME records. So there they are, K2 dot, etc. Okay, so that's all looking good. So we've now added them to Bluehost. We go back to Mailchimp and we click authenticate domain. Now, Mailchimp have just tried. Now, this can take a while. It usually takes a number of hours, even up to 48 hours, 28 to 48 hours, as Mailchimp says, and it will automatically keep checking for you. But if after 48 hours or so, you don't have green authenticated next to your domain, click authenticate and all should be fine. Once you've authenticated your domain in Mailchimp, you don't need to do it again. So we've done it once in Bluehost and that's it. We don't need to do it again. And now your emails are less likely to end up in the spam folder or go to the Gmail promotions tab. But thanks for joining me. My name's Gary from organicweb.com.au.